well. I was thinking we should get started soon. Hard to believe it's been 10 years since your daughter and son-in-law were lost here.
What were they thinking? Leaving their daughter behind and going to such a dangerous place? Are you sure you won't change your mind? Are you still determined to go back there?
It's too late to turn back now. I've spent my entire life working toward this. I can't turn back.
Mr. Werner von Blücher? Mr. Werner von Blücher?
That time already? Well, then I'll go on ahead, all right?
Mr. Werner von Blücher? Mr. Werner von Blücher? Please report to the central
hall. I guess Roald decided not to come, then.
Hmm? Oh, yes. She's a little upset at the thought of someone finding the Mother Lode before she does. After all, she's been looking for it all her life.
I've always been fond of Roald, you know that. But all's fair in love and war.
Nothing to report, sir.
Keep your eyes wide open. If any pirates show up, I want them taken care of immediately.
Yes, sir.
No one has journeyed to Forbidden Island and returned to tell the tale, but today two men who have devoted their lives to studying that infamous island...
Did you have to call so many reporters?
Can't have all the fun myself, can I? The more the merrier, wouldn't you agree?
You never change, do you? Just try not to make a fool of yourself or me.
Ladies and gentlemen of the press, thank you for your patience. I would like to present to you a brief description of our planned expedition.
Now tell me, just what do you think you're doing here? I thought you had gotten out of the pirate game, hmm?
Stuff it, Clyde. Mind your own business. We've got enough problems as it is.
What, did your little department store go under already?
Gah! No, it hasn't gone under. We're just a little in the red this month, that's all. Just need a little extra cash to make ends meet.
If you didn't buy only what you like, maybe we wouldn't be in this fix.
Shut your traps. I'm trying to listen to what he's saying.
What did you say, you big tin can? Who do you think you are?
No squabbling till the job's finished. Remember, Teasel?
Teasel!
As I'm sure all of you are aware, No one has succeeded in landing on the island beyond this tumultuous cloud and lived to tell the tale. No one, that is, except Professor Beryl and myself. 30 years ago, Professor Beryl and I journeyed to that island and returned. Over the years, we've been asked many times what we saw there. We have kept that knowledge to ourselves, but now I intend to give to you the opportunity to see it for yourselves.
Roald, breakfast ready. I made the eggs just the way you like them. Hey, look, it's Gramps.
Huh?
Don't worry, Roald. The Mother Lode can't be found that easily.
Oh.
Professor Beryl and myself are confident that the Mother Lode which has been sought after by all mankind for numerous generations, does lie buried somewhere on this island. This ends my presentation. Thank you. And now, are there any questions?
Excuse me, Mr. Blucher?
Yes?
Has your research given you any clue as to what exactly the Mother Lode might be?
That's a good question. Personally, I believe it to be something of tremendous importance to mankind. Something that will help us better ourselves and the world. Perhaps a new energy source, more powerful than our current refractors.
And you, Professor? Tell me, what do you think?
Well, I think... Matilda! You're alive!
That's her! That's the one who stuffed me into that locker!
Has it occurred to you that this great lost treasure might not be what you think it is?
Keep your eyes on her.
What happens to you is no concern of mine. Still, I'll give you this warning. What you call the Mother Lode is not what you think it might be. No, it's not a treasure at all. It's a catastrophe waiting to happen. Gats!
Don't move.
Stop! Hold your fire! Cease fire!
Look at that, Diesel! Isn't it amazing?
I smell a mighty big treasure, Tron!
Get out of my way, I can't see!
Whoa. Watch what you're doing! You're trying to get me killed!
I'm sorry, I didn't mean to cause such a ruckus. Still, the child must not be allowed to awaken. There's no telling what might happen if she does. Understand? You have been wrong.
A child? What do you mean, Matilda?
Mega Man, did you see that? That woman. She was my mother.
Huh?
But how? Why? My mother wouldn't do anything like that, would she?
Let's find out.
What?
Let's just go there and we can find out for ourselves.
But...
It's the only way to be sure, you know?
Oh, I guess you're right. Let's go. I'll get changed, then get the engine started. Can you clean up the dishes for me? Thanks.
Hello. Okay, so starting up Legends 2. Let's see. Yeah, that's fine. So that's what we're trying to go after in this game, the Mother Lode. Which totally isn't actually a catastrophe like it was in the first game, Awakening Juno under Cadillac's Island. Monkey.
Data, please, get Rule fast!
Boy, Mega Man, I'm disappointed. I thought
bet you we're braver than this. You can do it. Come on, Mega Man. Data, you stay out of Mega Man's way.
Boy, oh boy. You.
There. All done. Everything's in working order. At this speed, we should catch up to Gramps any time now.
Boy, that new engine sure is something. Completely different from the old one.
Well, it was expensive, but it was worth it. I'll take over.
Oh, thanks.
Data, it's almost lunchtime. Can you get everything ready? Mega Man, thank you.
Huh?
Well, I was a little down before, and... I was thinking, what would I do if they find the Mother Lode? I guess I got a little scared.
Scared? Why?
I've been searching for the Mother Lode because I thought if I found it, I'd be able to see my parents again. I guess I was just fooling myself. I've got to accept reality. Face the facts. They are gone. Both of them are gone.
Oh.
But still, when you said we should go see for ourselves, I remembered something my mother told me a long time ago. She said a digger should never give up hope.
Right.
My mom and my dad and the Mother Lode. I won't. I won't give up on them yet.
That's the spirit. We'll find them, Rule.
Anyway, Mega Man, what should we do once we catch up with Gramps' ship?
Mega Man sounds a little off-putting in this game. Probably because he switched over from a dude to a girl in this game. Since I'm pretty sure the mayor from the first game is voicing him in this. Can we land on that island?
The Flutter can't get through the wind surrounding Forbidden Island. We'll need a special ship if we want to land there. My father once designed a special kind of flying ship called a dropship. I'm pretty sure we could use it to get there.
Was that really your mother?
She does look a lot like my mother. But I can't believe my own mother would do something like that. I wonder who she is.
Where's my shit, Roll?
I'm really sorry, Mega Man. I needed to upgrade the Flutter. I'm afraid I sold all your equipment. Please forgive me.
So that's your explanation why for Mega Man has nothing in this game. She sold all his stuff.
Okay, we can figure out what to do once we get there, right?
Roll, do you smell something burning?
Mm-hmm.
Data! I'll go see what's wrong.
Wait, Mega Man, take this with you.
What? What is it?
It's a fire extinguisher. I'll tell you more later.
Okay, back me up.
You know how to use your fire extinguisher, right?
God damn it, Data.
Mission start.
So, the way special weapons works in this game is quite a bit different than how it worked in Legends 1. Because I think they realized how overpowered it was just letting you use it whenever you want. shit. I'm trying to help you, monkey. Settle down. There we go. Don't let monkeys cook. Gotta be one of the lamest names for a ship ever. The Sulphur-Bottom. We'll continue with live updates
throughout the day. Final check complete. We can get underway whenever you're ready, sir.
Understood. Well then, everyone, are you ready?
We won't let anything get in the way of a story. We're not like those wimpy TV reporters. You're really going to go through with this?
Yes, I am. I have to.
Well, if you're going to do it, then do it. I mean, we've come this far, right?
Thank you, Baron. All right then, let's go. Main engines online.
Main engines online!
Set course for the center of the island. Engage!
Looks like they're intent on ignoring my warning.
Weapons activated.
Remember, I don't want them hurt.
Understood.
The stabilizers on this ship are amazing. You can hardly feel the wind. I'm impressed. Huh?
Unidentified object approaching from above at high speed. Sir!
Activate defense grid. No one will stop me. Not now.
I got a bad feeling about this. Bond. Order the Drakes to go to yellow alert and stand by. Ready.
Here she comes.
Just a little more. Just a little closer.
Fire, now!
Visually, this game is a lot more impressive than the first one. I gotta give them that.
Fire repressors activated. Engines offline. She's out of control. Emergency escape pod launch mechanism damaged.
What? No.
Now you've really done it.
Apologies, Mr. Suna. We should retreat.
Yeah, Legends 1 was, I think, 97. And this came out pretty late in the PlayStation 1's life. I think, I want to say this was 2000. So they had about 3 years to work on this.
Roll! The sulfur bomb is being sucked into that storm!
Gramps!
What should we do?
We can't take the flutter in there. And we're almost out of fuel. We'll have to set down on a nearby island. We can figure out what to do then.
Thank you. A dropship. Okay, so, gameplay. Out making rounds? Okay. Can't climb up the ladder. So, in this game, Mega Man permanently has this new item called a lifter, which allows him to pick up enemies. Seen it before? Huh. There she goes. Okay, so I've currently got zero Zenny to my name. There goes roll. Oh, hey, a can. Yeah. Let's go get plastered at the bar. Mega Man! Proto Man! Guts Man! What are you doing on TV? Very interesting. It's a dog. Come to think of it, there was a girl who hated dogs on the last island we were on. She looks sober, but she's had a few, so don't pay attention to her. Just imagine, this is the kind of place that Phoenix Wright would have been playing piano at. Can I do it again? Doesn't matter. And look, Iceman. This is his house, huh? Okay, cool, so I can free look in this game. Cool. Can also use the analog stick, which is nice. If I wanted to. Tiger uppercut. Ooh, looks like I got a broken vacuum. Thousands, Zenny. Nice. Duck. Wee. This is so silly. So he won't climb the ladder. Trespassers keep out. Look, there's Iceman again. Choo-choo. Okay, the dodging still works the same way. Like fossils? Sure. Got a Reaverbot claw. Kidding, Mega Man. Okay, I think that's about everything we can check out here. There you are. Don't worry, he's alive! Oh god, so that's really who it is, huh? I don't remember if this was a plot point that comes up again so far. Like how this dude is related to Rule's dad. Rule, please move. Okay, let's head out into the wilderness. Oh, wait, hold on. Can also go inside the flutter, I think. Yeah, cool. At least Mega Man's room doesn't look so barren this time. There's barely a room before. Oh, 1,000 Zenny. Is that a painting of gnomes? Is that what I'm seeing here? Those are gnomes. Yeah, those are fucking gnomes. Small child and a monkey. She named him Mega Man after one of her favorite video game characters. In the Japanese version, he said that he wanted to call him Rock, just because his granddaughter was named Rule, and he thought it was a funny pun. Okay, that's enough of that. Damn! Thanks for the rainy day fun, Gramps. So, I guess her dad's name is Ben or Casket. Love, Matilda. Whew. So that was the last letter that she wrote to her father before she disappeared. 1,000 Zenny. Yeah, I got some money. It's my job to keep the toilet clean. Everyone likes a fresh bowl. What a thing to say. Zenny. That makes up for the 2k Zenny I just gave to Roll to fix the living room. Rapid fire. Okay, so rapid plus two. Better than nothing. Okay, let's get out of here. Bro, what are you doing? Anyway, let's go. So I think you can actually pick Roll up with the lifter, but she doesn't like it. Yep. She smacks you. Watch where you're going, bunny. Up here. Oh, hey there, boys. I think we kind of lost Roll somewhere. Anyway, let's go in. So, if select is for the I can just look at the menu like that. Okay. Right, so that's where Roll wants to go. But we don't want to go that way. We want to explore. Oh, never mind. There's nothing to explore this way. Okay, so the trick from Legends 1 still works, where you can tap shoot and the forward button to just to get like a kind of rapid fire. Okay, so there's a door over here. Hey, treasure! A broken model gun. Okay. Okay. Looks like we can just go back to roll now. Now we can follow after roll. Could have at least let me. Yeah. I want to fill out the area. What do we got in here? 100 Zenny. 300 Zenny. Okay, so that's a new type of Reaverbot we've not seen before. Old hover jets, nice. Oh, oh. More Zenny. Hold on. There we go. That's more like it. Okay, and then this area just loops. Okay, so let's move on. Refractor. Okay, so he passed out. Hey there, big guy. Whoa. Big ol' sweep attack. Got him. And goodbye. Hooray! Okay, room's filled out. Razor, the way Epic exclusives usually work is they have a contract to keep it exclusive for about half a year. But then after that, it goes off and then they can go to stuff like Steam. Razor may not even be watching this, so it doesn't matter. I got a refractor. So he's got amnesia. Okay, there she goes. We lost something important because of that ship. Hey, is that Calinca? I think that's Calinca from Mega Man 4. I see you there, Black Zero. I can't believe this woman hates diggers. What's her problem? Okay, so what do you have for me? So let's definitely buy the roller board. We'll buy some bionic parts, an energy canteen. I'll buy the normal armor. Thank you. So let's equip the normal armor. That's a power razor and range plus 2 would probably be good ideas. Okay, that'll be good for now. Maybe now that Smash is finally over, maybe we can finally get a fucking port of Kid Icarus Uprising to Switch. Okay, so it's cool we actually get like a world map this time. Let's go to Forbidden Island. Okay, so this is Forbidden Island.
Mega Man? Mega Man, are you alright?
Hear you, Roll. I'm okay.
Good. If you want to come back to the Flutter, just get into the dropship, okay? Alright then. Let's try and find Grant's ship. It looks like it's drifting. I'm getting a reading north of your position. When you're ready, try heading north and see what you can find.
Damn, look at all these broken ships. All the people that tried to come here and failed.
Mega Man, be careful! It looks like there's something under the snow in front of you.
I'll be okay. Probably. Ow. Maybe not. Thank you. Maybe just for this instance, rapid would be a little better. Yeah, there we go. That's much better. Huh? These people... What?
I'm picking up something. It looks like human life signs, but I'm not sure. We can come back and check it out later. For now, let's just keep looking for Gramps' ship.
Are they even alive?
What is it? Do you see something? I'm not picking up anything.
It's a girl with green hair. How peculiar.
It looks like there's a person or something up ahead, but how could that be?
Oh, jeez. I got knocked backwards into the previous area. Things can take quite a beating. Oh dear. Hey, wait a minute. That's the same sound effect the dogs use in Resident Evil 1. You can't fool me. Ow. Gotcha. That doesn't look suspicious at all. Okay, that wasn't too bad. Jeez. Ow. Hi, Data? How did you even get here? Beryl had mentioned in his diary that there was like a floating diamond that he saw. Also, I'm still dropping frames. Fuck's sake. Okay, let's try that again.
Can you see Brant's ship yet? According to my readings, it should be somewhere close by. Mega Man, what did you do? I'm picking up a massive energy surge. I think it might be a giant Reaverbot. Get out of there, Mega Man! Mega Man! Mega Man, hit me?
Oh boy. Oh, I'm gonna need range for this. Ow. There we go, that got him.
The storm, it stopped.
Uh-oh. Looks like Blucher's ship is gonna crash.
Oh, has it finally stopped? Oh, I thought we were goners for sure.
You're getting old, Beryl. That was nothing. Look at me. I'm fine.
Show off. For all that money you spent on it, you'd think this flying washtub of yours would have held up better.
Well, accidents happen. If we were ready for them, we wouldn't call them accidents, would we?
How come those old fogies are so chipper, huh? My stomach feels like it's been through a washing machine spin cycle.
Teaser. Look!
Looks kind of similar to the design on that on Matilda's bracelet.
Huh?
Oh. Hi there. That's a naked girl. And that's a butt.
Well, that's done it. They woke her up.
The Carbons have decided their own fate. This is because they've activated Mistress Sarah. You've done enough for them, Mistress Yuna. You are required to relinquish the keys to her.
No, it's not enough. Why did the Master entrust that purifier unit with his genetic code? It was his job to hunt down and eliminate all aberrant humans. So why did he become the greatest aberrant of all? There are still too many unanswered questions.
Mistress Yuna, surely you have enough information to arrive at a conclusion.
Think, Gats. What if the carbons, which the Master loves so dearly, were more important than the Master system? What then?
What? The chances of such a possibility being true are non-existent.
Are they? How can you be so sure? Uh-oh, we better get out of here.
Agreed.
No idea what the hell's going on.
It appears that Miss Yuna still does not intend to give you access to the keys, Mistress Sarah.
What is she thinking? Her logic is as mysterious as was the Master's. You know what you have to do.
Yes, the directive of this unit is ensuring your safety.
Very well. One of the carbon ships. We must first recover the keys to the library. We can acquire and deal with the Master's genetic code sample afterward.
You know, she must be freezing. As cold as Roll must have been wearing, like, shorts in a winter landscape. This woman's wearing nothing.
What gives? How come we end up stuck in here?
Think about it, Teasel. Do you think they're just going to have a press conference with what's happened?
What was that blue fellow doing there anyway? I don't like it enough one bit. One thing's for sure. I'll get him this time or my name's not.
Shh. I'm picking something up.
So what you're saying is, if you have possession of these four keys, we can unlock the Mother Lode and save Mistress Sarah. Is that it?
Correct. We are from the past, your ancestors. We are in a world we never made. We mean no harm. We simply desire to live out the rest of our lives as best we can. Of course, your troubles will be rewarded. With the keys, you will have access to technology that has long been lost to you. You would have the ability to make all the refractors you need.
I understand. Leave finding the keys to us. We are not the only ones searching for the Mother Lode. For your safety, I recommend that you stay here on the ship.
Yeah, this isn't suspicious at all.
Speak of the devil.
Why, you? Were you spying on me?
I thought we were supposed to be allies, aren't we?
We're a unified front, a team. We won't let you hold out on us. Unified front? There's only two of you!
Ah, but they are veterans, remember, Teasel. Not like some people I know who think the more people you have working for you, the better you are.
Oh, and what about you, you?
Now, Teasel, the more the merrier, right? Don't get so upset. We can dump them anytime we want.
I guess you're right. All right, then, let's get this show on the road. What we need to do is split up and take over any town that's got a large ruin nearby. Then, we explore the ruins and find these keys. All right, boys. Look sharp. Let's go.
I'll see you around.
Come in, Bola. We've got work to do.
Those two really get on my nerves.
Pirates on the move already? That complicates matters.
Oh, stop it. You can't fool me.
Is it that obvious?
Don't you think you're getting too old for playing around with pirates?
Find Mega Man. Bring him here.
Yes, sir.
You're not going to drag them into your escapades again, are you?
Well, I just want to talk to them. They'll get involved with or without me.
My, my.
Mr. Mega Man, sir. Mr. Bluka would like to see you.
Okay, so we're now on Blucher's ship. Yeah, it's not suspicious at all that there's one party saying that the Mother Lode is actually a wealth of knowledge that'll help out humanity, while there's the other party saying that it'll bring about a cataclysm. Not suspicious at all. Okay, so those people are called the Ancients. Nothing to do with the Ancients from Final Fantasy VII. Okay, so what he says matches with what Beryl says. Zenny! Nice! Okay, so these are for storing the keys. That's neat, I guess. That's an elevator. It's a caterpillar. Whoa. What are you doing here? So that goes up. Let's go down, I guess? Wait, no, that's just the dock. Let's check out the other lift. That'd be me, Mega Man. Yeah, you guys seem totally trustworthy. Serves you right. Zenny. Kilroy was here. Huh? Kilroy? I don't get it. Heavy-duty gear. Nothing of interest. M1000 Zenny. It's full of white powder! Oh, that's just flour. Never mind. I still don't know what that is, Sue. Okay, so let's see. There's no voice acting in Nick Smash, Rex. Let's buy the long barrel. We'll buy the bottle rocket. Padded armor. That'd be nice to have. Let's see. So I'd keep the range and get an extra attack on top of that. Sounds good to me. So can I enter these rooms now? Shit. Maybe if I talk to Roll first. Okay, so let's give her the mechanic notes. Okay, we got the jet skates. The machine gun arm. And the homing missile. Alright, so we finally have some special weapons. The Aqua Blaster is pretty much never used again, except maybe one or two times. Machine gun arm is back from the first game. Homing missile is new. $10,000, $15,000. Yeesh, that's a lot of money. Okay, there's the vacuum arm from the first game as well. Alright, we're ready to move out to Manda Island. There it is. Oh yeah, I've got the skis now. The jet skates. Yeah. It's nice you get the jet skates so early in this game. Kick him around.
Hmm.
Okay, time to explore us some sub-ruins. So we're running into these shield dudes pretty early, compared to when we found them in Mega Man Legends 1. Ow. Jesus. There we go. Okay, 3,000 Zenny. So for special weapons in this game, the blue bar is the actual ammo that capacity that you have for it, while the green one is like a timer. So the more you use it, the more the green bar goes down, and if it drops all the way down, then you have to wait till it starts refilling before you can use your special weapon again. They must have introduced it so that you wouldn't just spam your special weapons to solve everything in this game. Yeah, it's like an overheat system. Enemies do seem to be more likely to drop weapon energy in this game, though. At least it seems like it. Oh! They've gotten smarter! I can't just run off to the side to dodge its attacks now. Okay, so there's a wall there. In the first game, all you had to do to dodge those trap chests was just run to the side or behind them. But they've gotten smarter. Oh, by the way, this game hasn't talked about it yet, but there are status effects. You can be set on fire, which does damage over time. You can be essentially energy poisoned, which not only locks your buster, but reduces your special weapon energy. You can also be paralyzed if you're electrified, which makes you walk really slow. Ah! Jesus Christ! Just walked up on its own. Ow. Okay, so, maybe we should check out that other way. Nah, we're already here. Okay, more money. Always good. Loads of money. These walking chests are so goofy. Mechanic notes too. Okay, so this just loops me back around to that wall I could have destroyed if I had the drill. Okay. Alright, so let's check out that other path that I ignored. Down we go. Hey there, big guy. I remember you. Goodbye to that thing again. Much to Miko's disappointment, Rex, never. Nice. So most of the refractors that we find in this game, we can actually just sell for money. Which is nice. So changing floors in this game respawns the enemies. Oh, nice, I got like 50,000 Zenny. That's a huge leap in Zenny there. Wow. Let's do what we actually came here to do and go look for the key.
The Bluebird is here!
You've got the electronic jammer set up, right?
Yes, Miss Tron.
Let's see, the voice synthesizer is all set. Okay, begin Mega Man Special Plan 3!
Do you think it will work?
Maybe it will, maybe it won't. But that doesn't mean we won't try.
Yes, Miss Tron.
All right then, let's have some fun with Mega Man.
You hear that? Tron wants to have some fun with Mega Man.
Long time no see, Mega Man. I had a feeling I might run into you here.
You're looking as good as ever. Well, as good as you can, considering how that good-for-nothing blonde treats you.
Bruh.
What do you mean? When I ran into Miss Blondie, she told me all sorts of things. Like how she's glad she doesn't have to go out on digs with you. Do you think that's fair? She gets to relax while you run around getting shot at. Don't you think that's a little strange?
Well,
Wait, there's more. Haven't you ever noticed that she's keeping some of the money you give her for weapons development for herself?
I told you she was parched in this game.
What? Skimming?
She makes you all sorts of equipment and weapons, right? Do you really think it costs that much? You really are sick, aren't you? She was showing off how much money she saved by stealing from you.
Ro would never say those kinds of things.
How can you be so sure? You can't judge a book by its cover. She might look sweet and innocent, but how do you know what she's really like? Looks like it's working. Who'd have thought?
Oh, I was hoping you wouldn't find out about that, Mega Man.
What? Roll?
But I guess it's too late to try to hide it now that Tron told you. Don't worry about me. You don't need to come back. You could team up with Tron.
Roll?
What? I don't want him either. Well, maybe. If he gets on his hands and knees and begs me, I might consider it. You really don't care if I have him?
Me? No, not at all.
But...
Right, just wait till I get through with him.
Oh shit. She's gonna be, yep. And there's nothing I can do to stop this. You bitch! God damn it! She just destroyed every single building in this area.
Say things like that?
Say things like what? Are you okay, Mega Man? You didn't get hit in the head or anything, did you? Guess what's for dinner, Mega Man? It's your favorite, pizza.
Really? It's been a while since we had that.
Uh-huh. I even managed to find the
They really went out of their way to show that Tron butt there. Really out of their way.
It was a good idea. But it looks like their faith in each other can't be broken.
Look at him. Talking with her like they don't have a care in the world. Made a fool of me again. You...
What is it, Mega Man?
Oh, nothing.
Let's go. What's the matter, Miss Tron? I said let's get out of here.
Oops. There she goes. Hold on. I want to see if I can do that without her destroying every single building in the area. If possible. Now see, in the first game it wasn't too bad. You could just, like, stand by one of the walls in the city, and her attacks would pretty much not affect anything in the area. But here she has that giant spinning attack that I can't do anything about it. Because she's invincible while she's spinning around. She's gonna do this. Ow. Maybe if I can get her in, like, hold on. get her stuck in, like, an animation before I get her HP too low. Maybe I can do it. Because obviously trying to brute force it at this point is just not working. I don't think I can do this without her at least destroying 75% of the fucking village. Let me try one more time. Probably just really aren't supposed to save the village and just have to fucking contribute to the repairs. God damn it, I want to try. You know, it would be one thing if I could stop her goddamn attack.
Thank you.
All right, I guess there's no stopping her from destroying a majority of the village. Oh well. Damn, what a bitch. Symbol of the school is a question mark? So I may not have the opportunity to fix the village until I clear the ruins. Okay, so now we have the drill arm. And let's go back here. We're gonna go to the junk shop. Okay, so we can sell that refractor that we got for a good amount of Zenny. I will take that padded armor. I'll buy some bionic parts. And an extra pack of... for an extra pack for the energy canteen. Alright, so... unfortunately, we're gonna have to take the drill arm with us. Which I think is gonna be a pretty common theme for all the major dungeons that we go to. It's better to just bring the drill from the get-go so that we can drill through all the walls that we come across. Looks like I won't be able to really do anything else here until I get through the ruins, unfortunately. I guess you'd be lucky to even save one of the houses with that stupid attack of hers. Okay, so I think this will be a good place to stop since I've been going for about 2.5 hours. Next time, we'll take on the main dungeon of this place.